I'm about to speak, the bells go ballistic. It's 10:30. Anyway. Hey everyone, it's Hannah, and welcome to another Craftea Chat podcast. Craftea Chat, my crafty mug. I don't know why I just sang that. This is what I do. Apologies for the church / cathedral bells going berserk. It's 10:25. I thought I'd be safe. I am not safe. Apparently there's some kind of church service happening. I'm not quite sure. Anyway, welcome to the Craftea Chat podcast. This is a knitting and crochet and whatever other crafts I've been doing this week podcast. My name is Hannah, as I said, and you can find me online most places as The Corner of Craft. Exceptions are obviously gonna happen, but this is where you can find me. Thank you so much for watching this podcast. If it is your first time viewing, welcome to the podcast. I hope that you like it enough to hit the subscribe button and hit the thumbs up button. It really helps get my video out there into the open and all. Thanks so much. And if you're a returning viewer, nice to see you again. Welcome back. Hope you've had a good fortnight. Well, I've told you where you can find me on social media, but we also have a Ravelry group. I'm not overly active in the Ravelry group, and I'm gonna try really hard this fortnight to fix that. But we have a Craftea Chat podcast Ravelry group, link is in the description box. That is where you will find all of the information that I talk about in this podcast, the show notes, if you will. So I hope that you'll sit down with a cup of tea or whatever you're drinking and craft of your choice. And let's get chatting. So we are gonna start with whips and hose, and I don't actually have any half objects for you today. Oh, I forgot to say, it's Thursday the 26th of January. I don't think I've said that, but I don't have any half objects for you this week, apologies. But I still have three works in progress, and one of them you're probably, well, two of them you're sick of seeing. So I've got the mantilla doily. Still, I know. So this is a doily by Coates Design Team. It's not a difficult doily, but it doesn't have a chart, which I'm usually fine with because I don't read charts. But it's a little bit confusing how it's written. And I've done a fair few doilies. Here's one here. And I've spent so much time on this now. I just kind of want it done. And I'm on the home straight, but I'm not close enough to being done where I can just plow through, because rows are long now. Well, the rounds are big. I'm not quite sure how to phrase that. I'm just gonna pull this end through so I don't drop anything. I suppose I could add a stitch marker on it, but that is a clever thing to do. So this little stitch marker here marks where I was last time. This little start is by Pixel Pearls. And so I've done a few rows and I'm halfway through a round now because this is the beginning of the round. Oh, I go around this way. So I'm over halfway through around because I'm over here. But yes, this is where I am now. I'm trying to adjust the focus once again. Wow, these cathedral bells are going berserk. I do apologize. But yeah, it's taking shape. It obviously will need blocking once it's done. I'm not quite sure how I'm gonna do that. I don't know if I have anything large enough. But I don't know what I'm gonna do with it when it's done. It's bigger than I thought it would be. But it might just go on the coffee table or something. Because I started this in September and I'm still making it. And I haven't worked on it particularly hard, but I tried to get out a good slog of it this past week actually. And I've done quite well, but I just got fed up, I'll be honest. And then the other thing I'm working on is my Cozy Memories blanket. Because I said I hadn't done much work on it last time I spoke to you, which was 2 weeks ago. And now I have, and that's the wrong way around. So this is the pattern by Kemper of Junk Yarn, Kemper Ray. And I'm following it to a T. A lot of people have adapted theirs, but I didn't have the knitting skill when I started to know how to adapt it. So I'm following it straight, and I'm even sewing my ends in as I go, except for one per square so I can sew up a corner if I need to. But yeah, wah! So I was here last time I spoke to you, So I'd done this one, because there's another charm by Anna. And then now look where I am. So I've added so many squares. I was hoping to get the row finished, but I didn't. So these are all, they're not all minis that people have given to me. A lot of them are minis that people have given to me. And I'm partway through a row, partway through a square, because I'm really skilled. This one I used on socks for Christmas presents. This one is my Christmas Eve cast on socks, Ana and Carlos in the Summer Nights colorway. This is one that I'm wearing around my neck right now. And I'll talk about that a bit later. This one is also one that I used for Christmas socks, that, as in Christmas present socks. And I'm desperate to knit myself a pair of socks out of this. But yeah, it's going well. I'm really enjoying knitting it. I've knit on it a relative amount, obviously, this past fortnight. Basically, as soon as I stopped podcasting last week, I thought, well, I better start working on it. And now I've only got three squares to go, and well, three and the most of this one, until I round it off, which is really good, and I'm really proud of myself. So it's kind of like a work in progress and a finished object. But yeah, a lot of people are saying they're not showing it every week, but I'm really proud of myself. I really like my blanket, and I'm going to force other people to look at it till they're sick of it, and I hope that's okay with you. So on this, I'm using one of my stitch markers that I have made myself. So for those who don't watch my other videos, I bead weave. This is bead weaving. It's really sturdy. So these are sewn together seed beads one by one. And it's a little sloth slash sloth. And I think I'm gonna start stocking these in my Etsy shop. I might put them in on Monday. That might be a thing that happens. Because I got a couple. So I've got the sloth, obviously. And then I've got a TARDIS. Because who doesn't love Doctor Who? And like I say, these are all handmade. Beads are sewn together one by one. Like, they're not quick things. And I've got this dark unicorn that I'm thinking of stocking, and I've got a couple of other light fluffy unicorns as well. I've got them on these leverback earring findings, because then you can use them in both knitting and crochet. You can use them in crochet hooked around like this, you can use them in knitting, sorry, as just like a normal stitch marker, or you can use them as a progress keeper if you prefer, you know, whatevs. So yeah, keep an eye on my Etsy shop, because I think I might stock them, because I am proud of them and I like them. Also, I realise I never discuss what tea I'm drinking, and that's because I 99% of the time drink the same tea. I'm usually drinking Twinings English Breakfast Tea. And fun fact, since moving to Germany, because I am in Frankfurt, I'm done terribly with the introduction this morning. I'm from Britain. I'm currently living in Frankfurt, Germany. But since moving to Germany, I drink more tea than when I lived in England. Strange. I have one more work in progress for you all. And it's kind of fattening up my stash as well, even though it's not stash because I'm using it. So it's Mario's birthday at the beginning of March. And I went into Karstadt because I needed some yarn for one of my finished objects, which I will show you in a little bit. And I saw that they had this yarn on sale for only €2.49. So I thought, this is a nice boy colour. Not that there are boy colours and girl colours in the world, obviously, because, you know, it's just colour. But it's called Mint Julep. It's colour 06450. And it's knitting up like this. And, yeah. I thought, yeah, for €2.49, I will buy two balls of that and knit Mario a pair of socks. I was originally going to knit myself the socks, and then thought, I should probably knit him socks for his birthday. So I started them yesterday. Because I want them to be a complete surprise. He doesn't know I have the yarn. He doesn't know that I've cast these on. He doesn't know I'm knitting on them. So I have to knit them while he's at work, which isn't a problem. But yeah, so I'm knitting these on 2.5 millimeter higher sharp. Now I'm a magic loop girl. Who'd have thunk it? I'm keeping this in my Truly Hooked hand-dyed sock bag, which smells really good, which is a really weird statement to say, but it does, it just smells nice. And I like this bag because one, it's drawstring, and two, you can keep three balls of yarn in it, like little 50 gram balls. So for heels, toes, and cuffs, I am doing a contrast. And I'm just using this Wollerödel Strumpfwolle. Wollerödel is a wool shop that is close to me. And it's the Strumpfwolle, and it's color 035, which is just this dark charcoal gray. And it goes with it, so I thought, why not save me buying any more, because I use this on a finished object that I have. And yeah, this color is the mint julep color. It's Regia yarn, design line jazz color by Erica Knight. So yeah, mint julep is the name of it, and I'm quite enjoying it. And also, because I've been knitting my socks on 2.25 millimeter needles, it is nice to go back to a 2.5, I won't lie. Quite delightful, in fact, because everything knits up much faster. I've cast on 72 stitches, and I learned a new cast on yesterday. So I learned how to do the German twisted cast on, and it's stretchier. And that was Mario's request, because I knitted him socks for Christmas. He's gonna be sick of the socks, but he likes wearing them. That was Mario's request. He said, is there any chance that, you know, we could have a stretchier cast on? And I said, well, I'll see what I can do. And I've done it. So that is something I have accomplished, and I feel very proud about it. Also, we had a bit of a laugh at knitting group the other week, because we discovered that how I knit is how one knits with straight needles, not how one knits with circular needles. I mean, it works. I'll never be able to use a 9-inch circular, but it gets the job done, and I can knit while looking at you. And where's the shame in that? You know? Okay. I'm gonna put this down midway through a row and pick it up later. So, now we're going on to finished things, and let's talk about the first finished thing that I'm wearing around my neck. You're all the finished things this week. Bah! It's my all about that brioche shawl. It's not been blocked yet, I will say that, because I haven't blocked anything before, and I don't have blocking mats, and I need to get some blocking mats, and I'm relatively new to the knitting game, all right? Not my fault, but I've done brioche. So this is the All About That Brioche Shawl by Lisa Hannes. It's got a nice brioche section. If you follow me on Instagram, you're probably sick of seeing this, so apologies, but also super proud of myself, so sorry, not sorry, it's one of those. This is my first finished object of 2017. This is my first time doing brioche. This is my first time using indie dyed yarn. So there's a lot of firsts kicked into this. Oh, I'm really proud of myself. I'm so proud I put it on my head. So the yarn I used is German dyed yarn by Das Mondschaf, which means the moon sheep, which is a really cute name. And the orange color is called Hokkaido. And then the bluey tealy color is called Vollmondnacht, which is just like full moon night, night of the full moon, literal translation, full moon night, Vollmondnacht. Sometimes my brain struggles with the whole translating into English thing, and I just have to say the words as they appear and wait for someone to make it sound English. But yeah, da-da-da. Super soft yarn, even pre-blocking. I'm really excited to block it and make it a bit bigger, because it's curved at the top, and I just want to stretch it out just a little bit and straighten it out. And like, I don't want to stretch it too much, because I like how squishy garter stitch is, and I like how squishy brioche is, so I don't want to block it too intensely, but just a little bit, you know, just to make it grow slightly. But yeah, I've entered this into a couple of cowls. So I've entered this into the Cold Shoulder Cowl, which is hosted by both the Legacy Knits podcast and also by I'll Knit If I Want To podcast. I've entered it into that. And then Louise Tilbrook, I think is her name, runs the Everyday Knitter Facebook group and Ravelry group, and they had a brioche challenge in January. I finished it just in time. And then Amber of the Yarn Hoarder podcast hosted a multicolored shawl cow. And this is multicolored. It's got two colors, that's more than one. So yeah, I'm entering all the knit alongs at the minute and it's a good feeling. Speaking of knit alongs, I finished my socks, my first pair of socks of 2017. So these are my Hufflepuff socks because they're yellow, but then they have the gray heels, toes, and then the cuffs with the yellow stripe. And I'm very proud of them and I really like them, and I was playing so much yarn chicken at the end, it was slightly stressful. Also, I put down these socks quite a long time because I wanted to finish this. And so when I picked them back up again, this is my second sock, and I can tell because my tension on my foot is looser than the tension on this one. Also, I knit most of this foot in the cinema. I'm really proud. My first successful cinema knit, although I did knit in the cinema for Rogue One, but there was a light behind, so I kind of cheated. But this was a proper cinema knit, and we saw Assassin's Creed, and I'm glad I have my knitting. That's all I'm gonna say. Mario really enjoyed the film. Mario is my boyfriend. For those who don't know, Assassin's Creed is a film based on a video game. He has played all of the video games, I think, most of them. And I've watched him play a lot of them, but obviously I haven't been paying that much attention to them because I had no idea what was going on most of the time. So that's fun. But yeah, I say speaking of knit along, because these are also getting entered into a crap ton of knit alongs. So these are my first socks of 2017. This means they'll be going in my Boxo socks. The Yarngasm podcast is hosting a Boxo socks 2017. One was hosted last year and I learned how to knit socks too late and got into knitting podcasts too late. So Boxo socks. These are also being entered into KTM Inside Number 23's Harry Potter Knit Along. And the Happy Knitting Podcast is having a Geeky Sock Along. So these are ticking all the boxes. So now I need to cast on another pair of socks myself to knit of an evening, because I can't knit these in the evening, which is why I've started them so early, because I don't want Mario to see them. Blah, blah, blah. Anyway, all the knit alongs. Then my final thing that I made, and you would have seen these everywhere, but I've done a crochet one. It's the kitty hat. It's the kitty cat hat. I'm gonna have to slouch in my chair. And then I like to bend the ears forward like this and sort out my hair. And let me tell you, this hat is toasty. So yeah, for the Women's March that was on Saturday, and yes, I went to it. They had one in Frankfurt, and no, the numbers weren't as big as the ones that, as the like main cities in the States, but we still had over 2,000 people marching, which I think is pretty impressive. Yeah, so I decided to make a cat hat for myself because I thought I'm going on the march, I need a hat, and gosh, my hair. So this is the kitty ear beanie. This pattern wasn't released for the purpose that I used it for, but I don't mind. This is by Kayla Mullins and it is chunky. So I went to Karstadt, like I said, when I bought the yarn for Marion socks, I went to Karstadt, which is just like a department store, because they had cheap yarn and the cheap yarn was half price. So 99 cents per ball. I've got two balls, you can't really tell, almost kind of blown out a little bit. But I held two yarns together to make this and I used a chunky ass hook. I used a 9mm hook, which is pretty chunky. And I chose to crochet instead of knit it because one, I haven't crocheted in a while because I'm all about that knitting at the minute. And two, I thought it'd be a bit quicker because I don't really have chunky circular needles. So I've gone with a chunky hat. And it even got like fake ribbing, which is done by crocheting in front of post and behind post, like front post crochet and back post crochet. Super easy to do. I like it. I'm glad I made it. Not bad for €2. I already had the hook, so that made life easier. But I could have made it for free because I already had a skein of acrylic pink yarn. But I wasn't organized enough to actually look at what yarn I had, which is 100% my bad. But yes, I'm really glad that I participated in that march. I'm not going to get political because that's not what this is about. But there was something extremely moving and empowering and inspiring about doing that march. It had more of an effect on me than I thought it would. Does that make sense? I think that makes sense. But by gum, was it cold in the shade. My goodness, it was a beautifully sunny day here, but we walked around a lot of the streets and it was predominantly in the shade because there were quite tall buildings, obviously. And yeah, really cold. I was not wearing enough layers, which is completely my bad. Saturday was a hectic day. Anyway, so that is all my finished objects for this week, which is pretty good. I'm quite impressed about that. I've got quite a lot done. Got 3 finished objects. The hat you hadn't even seen. I forgot to say the hat took me 4 hours to make. Not bad. I'm a slow crocheter, which is ridiculous because of the length of time I've been crocheting, but for some reason I just can't seem to speed it up, you know? Also, I forgot to say, for my Hufflepuff socks, I did a fish lips kiss heel, which is surprisingly difficult to say. And whilst I enjoy knitting the heel and have the pattern memorized, not entirely sure how I feel about the fit of it. I don't hate the fit of it. It fits on my foot. I used 2.25mm needles to knit this, so it's super dense, which I like because my socks stretch. But I don't know. I think I prefer the fit of a heel flap and gusset, as much as I hate knitting, having to like decrease. And plus I'm going to have to revisit how to do them because I've kind of forgotten that I need to do them for Mary's socks. But yeah. So that's my small tangent for the moment. So I'm gonna take this hat off now because I'm getting a bit warm. So speaking of all of the knit-alongs, I'm gonna talk about a knit-along that I will be doing starting February the 1st. So my dear friend and neighbor, Becky, aka Soprano Knits, aka host of the Stringing It Together podcast, is doing her first, not her first, she's done a knit-along. She's doing a knit-along, it's the first one that I'm participating in. And she's doing the Euro Stash Cow, which is super cool. It's basically, she's encouraging people who have yarn that is dyed by European indie dyers. Obviously, Britain is included in this because they are in the continent of Europe. Even though, like, we're not on the mainland. But I'm sorry, that sounded really stupid, but sometimes it takes me a moment to remember things. Anyway, all I've had today is an apple. Crumbs, I can tell. Yeah, she's having the Euro Stash Cow. So, if you have any yarn dyed by European indie dyers, head on over to the thread that she has and let people know of some European indie dyers. She says she's doing this for mainly selfish reasons because she said since moving to, she is from the States, she said since moving to Germany she's realized how expensive shipping is from the States, and it is absolutely ridiculous. I was looking at some yarn yesterday and I think it was £21 the yarn and shipping was £11. That's over half the price of the yarn just to get it shipped here. And then you gotta pay customs on top of that. So yeah, really, really sucks. that I will be participating in the Euro Stash Cow, because I have quite a lot of European dyed yarn, because that is where I am. As I said before, I've got my Truly Hooked hand dyed. I've got some socks. I showed this last week. I got some sock yarn that I'm going to knit. I've got sock yarn that I bought in Barcelona that I'm going to knit. And I've got two skeins from Truly Hooked that I need a third for. I'm torn between either getting a dusky pink or a light grey. Thinking it's going to be a complete Truly Hooked shawl. And I'm going to make Becky's pattern, which is the Bechlein shawl, which I think would be pretty cool. Yep. Beep, 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 beep. So that's the knit along I'm going to be participating in next. Obviously, I will be participating in Boxo socks also, because I'm going to be knitting socks. But yeah, I just thought that I would let you know about that knit along, because I don't know, I think it's a good idea. I think it's a really cool idea. You can knit whatever you like as long as you use yarn that's dyed by a European indie dyer. And that's really cool, because shipping from Europe to the States isn't that expensive, but the other way around is extortionate. Anyway, enough about that. So now we are moving on to podcaster recommendations. I try to recommend 3 podcasts, but that's not something I promise I'm going to be able to continue doing forever. But I have 3 for you this week, and 2 of them are British. So that makes me feel good about life. So first off, we have the Green Lambkin podcast. I mentioned Green Lambkin last week because I knitted some of her yarn into my blanket. The Green Lambkin podcast is hosted by Suzanne, who owns Green Lambkin's Yarn, and she is based in England, close to where I moved from. And yeah, she has a relatively new podcast, and she is a lovely lady, and she has very cute kittens, or as with the cats, but all cats are kittens, right? That's a thing. And is a talented knitter and very talented yarn dyer. So, oh, and she also makes her own patterns. So it's really fun to see like a pattern process, because I've never made my own knitting pattern before, and it's just interesting to see. So that is my first recommendation. Second recommendation is the Quarrelsome Rhinoceros podcast, another relatively new podcast. This is hosted by Monica, who isn't in Britain. And she's in the States. I can't remember where I was going to say, but I've completely forgotten. Also creates lovely things and is a relatively new podcast as well, and is a friend of mine. So go over and check her out. And then finally, we have a new podcast that I discovered called the Tea and Possibilities podcast. Now, obviously, if you've been on my channel for 5 minutes, you know that I'm a little bit obsessed with tea, and I don't know what it is about it that makes me obsessed with tea. I just really enjoy it. So the Tea and Possibilities podcast is hosted by Nikki, who has just moved to London from Portsmouth, which is nice because I am from near Portsmouth, so it is nice to hear a familiar accent, and also another very talented podcaster who also sews, which is pretty cool. Always jealous of people that sew. I have a sewing machine that sat in that corner that has stayed in the box since I brought it here. So yeah, those are my 3 podcast recommendations. I hope that you go and check them out and show them some love. Oh, I forgot to say, totally going to Edinburgh Yarn Festival. We booked it. I'm so excited. So now we're moving on to a new segment, which is the Ask Me Anything, or I haven't thought of a better name for it yet. And because I have a thread in my Ravelry group, which is like a questions thread, so you can ask whatever you want in there and I will answer it on the podcast. And the other day I was asked if I play any musical instruments like a ukulele, and funnily enough, I can play the ukulele. Not that well, I'm really bad at it. I used to play the piano and I used to be all right at that, but then I stopped practicing and have since forgotten. Then I did also used to play the clarinet, and once again, forgotten how to do that. But I've been part of many choirs in my life growing up, so I guess I can kind of consider my voice to be an instrument. It's sometimes not as in tune as it should be, but I really enjoy singing in choirs, and I did it a lot over Christmas. That was really nice and good fun. Yeah, quite enjoyed that. And then on my YouTube channel yesterday, actually, I got a message on my How I Knit video asking how I store my knitting needles. And I guess I'm super fortunate in the fact that I don't have too many. My circular needles, I keep them in the cases that they came in, so I know what size they are and such. And then I got my higher sharp interchangeables that I got for Christmas. And they are here. This set is on loan at the minute, but yeah, so they just all stay in there, which is nice and handy dandy. And then when I first started knitting more, my grandma, bless her, because she can't see to knit as well anymore. Well, she can't see to knit full stop, which is really sad because I knew her only knitting growing up. So, oh yeah, here's an example of my needles being stored in their packets. But then my grandma, bless her, went through her knitting needles and put together a roll for me with one of my cousins who matched up numbers and needles, and then put them in this really old case, which is super cute and I really like it. So you can, this is the really confusing thing that I find about knitting and the whole number thing, because in the States numbers are different to how they are. Obviously they have numbers instead of millimeters. So what number are these? That's, no, it isn't the wrong one. So these 2.5 millimeter needles are US 1.5. And growing up, my mum used to talk about needle sizes in the old fashioned British way. Because the United Kingdom used to have different numbers to how they, we just go by millimeters now. But this knitting case, I don't know if you can see, potentially not. For example, a 5.5 millimeter needle is a 5. A 4 millimeter needle is an 8. And so on and so forth. And it's just crazy. So yeah, I have one set of, I have some needles in a roll, and I think one needle's fallen out the bottom, but I need to find that somewhere. And they're just super old straight needles that my grandma gave me. And then some I could just keep like this. And then I got my higher sharps in a little nice condensed little pouch. So that's how I store my needles. And then I've got crochet hooks as well. And I store my crochet hooks in this pouch, which I think I might need to either buy or make another one, because the Velcro is gone on this now, which is sad. But it is old and I have used, well, it's 3 years old and I have used it loads. And then any larger sizes I just keep in here. Oh, so this is exciting. So I talked about wanting to dye yarn. And these are my blank skeins of yarn. I haven't dared open them and see how soft they are or anything yet. But I didn't buy expensive yarn. It's going to be an experiment. I have dyes as well. I bought the primary colors and I've got a black, a brown, and an ecru. Because I figured they'd be useful colors. So all I need to get now is citric acid and a pot and some squeezy bottles and some gloves. And then I'm away. Although I have my hair dyeing gloves, so I guess they'd work. But you know, heat-proof gloves would be better. So yeah, those are the two questions that I received. Now I'm going to talk about life very briefly, because my camera's going to run out of battery, and my YouTube channel, what videos have been posted and such. So if you're not interested, thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to hit subscribe and to hit the thumbs up button. Let me know that you enjoyed it. And let's just jump on to life and YouTube stuff. So to start with, my YouTube videos this week have been this cute cat pin, which is also bead weaving. And I just glued some felt and a pin back onto it, but you can use it however you like. And then I also showed you how to make a friendship bracelet, if that is something you're interested in. Not only did I show you the four basic knots in last Thursday's video, but I just also showed you how to make this one. So yeah, those are the YouTube videos that you may have missed, or that is what has been happening on my channel. Now I'll just very quickly talk about life stuff because my camera battery is flashing at me. Like I said, I did the march last Saturday and that was super fun. I really enjoyed doing that. And after the march, I went to see one of my, a couple of my friends were in a play. So we went to see that, which was super cool. And then I went on a night out on the Saturday evening because it was one of my friend's birthdays and I got a little bit tiddly and danced a lot and it was a lot of fun. Yeah. I don't really think I have an awful lot else to report that I've done really, which sounds really sad, but it's just been pretty standard. I've got one of my really good, well, I lived with her when I lived just outside of Paris. When I lived in France, I suppose I could just say. But yeah, one of my friends who I lived with when I lived in France is coming to visit tomorrow and I'm really excited because I haven't seen her since I went to her wedding 2 years ago, almost 3 years ago, because she lives in Finland. But she's coming to visit, so that's very exciting and we should have a lot of fun. But other than that, it's just kind of standard things. I might try to stay up and watch the Super Bowl, but it kind of goes on till 5 a.m. and then my boyfriend's got work the next day, so I don't know if that'll happen. And yeah, not an awful lot else to report really. That's about it. Had a yarn exchange at knit night and that was fun. I felt really bad because I didn't take any yarn to exchange because I like all my stash, but still came away with some stuff, so I feel a bit guilty about that, but they said it was okay. It was kind of, yeah, I just feel bad. Anyway, thank you so much for watching this podcast. Like I said before, if you enjoyed it, thumbs up, subscribe, all of that fun stuff. I post a new tutorial on a Sunday and then I post a podcast every other Thursday and then a different video the Thursdays in between. And yeah, links to the Ravelry group can be found in the description box below. That is where you'll find all the information about the patterns and the yarns and the stuff that I use. I'm really scared that my battery's gonna die, so I'm just gonna sign off. Thank you so much for watching this video. It really means a lot that you take some time out of your day and spend it with me. Sorry it was a bit shorter this week. I did guess I didn't really have as much to say. Plus, my camera battery is against me. Serves me right for not charging it up. Thank you so much for watching, and I shall see you very soon in Sunday's video. Bye.